Michael Nunn, this is William Trevitt. We're here in Havana, Cuba, to witness the Royal Ballet's first ever historical visit to this city. They're bringing nearly 100 dancers, and they're going to be performing just over there at the Gran Teatro, the oldest opera house in Latin America.
In July 2009, Britain's Royal Ballet made history. They became the first major ballet company to be invited to Cuba since Castro's revolution of 1959. They performed to an audience with an unquenchable thirst for the arts in a country where ticket prices are enviably affordable. The success of this trip relied on the influence of one dancer. Although adopted by British audiences, Carlos Acosta remains Cuban at heart.
With a British twist.
Thousands gathered in Havana's main square to watch ballet relayed live on huge screens. The works that the Royal Ballet chose to perform were a brave mix of old and new. Wayne McGregor's ultra-modern Chroma and Sir Frederick Ashton's classic, A Month in the Country. And for one night only, the Royal Ballet was joined on stage by the stars of the Cuban National Ballet to perform an array of show-stopping duets as a tribute to their founder, Cuban prima ballerina, Alicia Alonso. Without her, there would be no ballet in Cuba. With such a tough schedule, illness and injuries are inevitable and every dancer's worst nightmare. So to keep dancing, they'll do almost anything. Completely unprecedented and unrepeatable, this was a truly spectacular occasion that could only have happened here. For Carlos, what had seemed like an impossible dream had just come true.
Es historia, es Royal Ballet en La Habana, caballero.